How do you recover from the corona symptoms in less than 7 days? Namaste everyone, my name is Vasundhara Talwari and I'm flooded with these questions from my near and dear ones and my clients as to how and what they can do to take charge of their lives during these fearful times. I, for myself, have gone through the corona symptoms. I've had those when I had just come back from the US. And when I saw myself having the shivers, the temperature, the body ache, the breathing, the congestion in my chest, I knew it was that. But I did not go to the doctor and got it tested because, one, I did not want to expose myself to the environment where there were confirmed patients. So that's one for sure. Now, if you have something like that going on in your body too, just make sure that you do the following and take great, great care of your own self. One, what do you do? Please do not become fearful. Like the famous Gabbar from the movie Sholay says, "Jo dar gaya, wo mar gaya." Isn't it? That's so true. If you become scared, your immunity system drops. When your immunity system drops, the virus can create more havoc in your body. Your recovery becomes more sluggish, more slow. Isn't it? So why become fearful? The mortality rate of this virus is supposedly less than 1%. Whereas even the normal flu that we usually get when the weather changes is more than 1%. So why should you be fearful? So one, please do not entertain fear. Please don't make it a part of your life. Doesn't have any space. Yes, especially when you are confident of taking the following next actions, isn't it? So step two, please inhale steam. Take some water in a vessel, boil it, and once you boil it, get it on your table, stool, wherever, and take a towel and inhale the steam. Cover yourself up so the steam doesn't escape. It's all you and the steam. And once you're covered in the towel, just inhale the steam, exhale. Inhale the steam, exhale. Do that for a good 15 minutes. Time yourselves on your phone. It'll clear up your passages. Wherever there's this virus that has gone into through one of your passages will be killed. These viruses do not stay alive in hot temperatures. So make sure you do that. Make sure that you do salt water gargles. How do you do them? Take some lukewarm water, add some salt, quite enough quantity that it becomes saltier than your tears. Yeah, do that and gargle really hard, gargle for long and spit it out. Do that again, do that for like good 5-7 minutes every day, twice a day. So whatever stuck somewhere in, again, those passages, this is how the virus gets into your body, right? So they are stuck somewhere in your passages, especially when there's sore throat. This will help eradicate, kill them there itself before they get into your body. So do that as soon as you have this little irritation. Don't wait for it to become worse. Must do is pranayama, controlled breath work. Nice long inhalations, holds and exhalations. I have some videos uploaded on my YouTube channel, so go have a look. Or if you have any access to anything else, please go practice this beautiful practice of pranayama, controlling of your prana, which is the energy, the life force that runs through you. And whenever the immunity goes down, the life force also goes down. So make sure with pranayama practice, you build it up again. Sit in the sun. Wherever you see the sun, make sure you're sitting there for at least 30 minutes. Time yourself, not less than 30 minutes. Morning, evening, both times, even better. So you can read a book, you can do whatever else you can think of while you're sitting in the sun. Just sit, close your eyes and meditate. You can do that. You can doodle, paint, do whatever you think. Be on your phone. Whatever it takes to be for you to be in the sun, please do that. Number six, sleep a lot. Your body needs rest. don't underestimate this pleasure, this luxury of sleep. It's free and it's a must. Your body needs to recover, repair, do a lot of hard work. When you're moving about, you're doing something, you're consuming even content online, you're not resting your body. So please make sure that you are sleeping at least for 8 hours to recover fast, less than 7 days. And the most important part of this is do some light asanas. That's the seventh point. Very light, nothing intense, nothing that will put a lot of pressure on your body. But just while you're lying down, just move, twist, stretch, you know, turn. Do that so that your body, whatever toxin is getting stored in your body, gets mobilized. And it's easier for your body to then flush it out of your body, because this is the time the body needs to flush out as much unwanted material, garbage that has got into it. So you're just making its task easier. But very light movements, nothing intense. Great. So this is what you need to do. I recovered in less than 7 days. And the most important part, the eighth point that I did not have in mind, but I'd love to share with you, is have something going on that is bigger than your little problem here of corona. You know, that's what I did. I launched my 21-day challenge while I was down with these symptoms, and I started shooting for it when I did not have the right equipment, and I just went with the flow. So my agenda was to, all right, what can I do to help people? What can I, how can I be of service to others? And that consumed me and took me away from feeling the symptoms. Yeah. So if you can think of what bigger than the problem can you take interest in and become one with that. Yeah. So that's the eighth suggestion. If you can take it up, please do. Otherwise, make sure the first seven is something that you're following. Hope you liked my recommendations, and please take care of yourselves. Do not become fearful. There's nothing to fear. Just stay strong. Take the precautions. Eat well. Breathe. Take the sun in. Kill those germs. Take charge of your life. Live a free life. Thank you for watching. If you liked it, please share it with your loved ones and subscribe to my channel by clicking my subscribe button right there. And thank you for watching. You wonderful people. I love you very, very much. Mwah.